this a rice cooker?
Hey, y'all.
Is that a rice cooker?
That's a pressure cooker.
Oh, okay.
I have been busy spring cleaning, although some people it may not seem like it. But I think this is going to be my first video for Feel Good Friday. And I've been out working in my garden all week. I'm exhausted. So I don't have the energy to be cooking no meals. So you my chronic pain sufferers, my fellow pain sufferers, I got a recipe for you. And I'm going to do it in real time just to show you how quick it really is. Okay? And I wanted to do this in the daytime before the sun sets, because it's so dark in here without the sunlight. All right. First step. You see my knife? I just got it. I got a good deal on it. You know, I got it.
It's red.
No, at County Market. It was in clearance.
How much was it?
It's these knives usually cost way more than $2. $2 I paid for this knife.
Okay, nice.
And by Chicago Cutlery. And it was a coincidence. I didn't even know it. But my cutting board that I inherited from my auntie was Chicago Cutlery, too.
Oh, no.
I didn't know that. Huh?
Coincidental.
Yeah, that was very coincidental. But check this out, y'all. When I first tried to make this, I had no clue what I was doing. None. And I followed a recipe that had me baking it. And it took an hour. But on a day like today where I've been working in the yard all day, I'm tired. I ain't gonna wait no hour for my meal. Okay, and so I need a sharp knife, cut this in half. I hope this goes through. It don't seem like it's sharp enough. Hold on a minute, I don't want y'all to see me struggling.
Yeah.
Okay, the new knife I bought did not work, so I had to get my tried and true little paring knife. Sucker. Cut through a lot of stuff. Alright. You see, cut it in half. And then the next step, you clean out the seeds. And guess what? I'm not going to throw the seeds away.
All right, you're
going to
plant them.
I'm going to plant these bad boys because I happen to love this plant. I didn't know I loved it till I tried it. So, you clear out, scoop up all the seeds out.
Like a pumpkin.
It's something like that. I tried butternut squash, but I didn't like that. Oh. I don't like the pumpkin butternut sweet taste. But this I do. Okay. Clear out the seeds. And I'm going to plant these suckers in my garden. And I make it two. Normally I make one. But I got a friend here with me today.
Hello.
And I want to turn her out. Turn her out on this dish because it's so easy. When I found out how easy it was, because I did it in the oven my first time doing that stuff, took an hour.
Did it taste good?
And it was good, but it was delicious. And my son, he was scared to try it. Dude, what's that? Dude, what's that?
Did he eat?
Y'all can't be like that. Because your mama, I don't remember my mother ever bringing nothing like this in the house. So you got to open up your mind. All this meat is killing us. So I'm on a journey to find out more plants that I like. And I've seen a lot of people growing tomatoes. I hate tomatoes, so you don't get what you hate. But I took a chance and got hip to something new. Once you scrape the inside out Me, I put my little seasoning in. You can season it to taste. I'm going to ask my friend, do you like garlic?
Yeah.
Okay, I got it.
Just go ahead and use all the same stuff you use. This is my first time tasting it, so.
All right, so I put the little seasonings in that I like. Keep Mrs. Dash. Take one in. And love me some garlic. And I put that in. This is a garlic salt from Aldi's. Inexpensive. You know, they be crazy with them prices in the grocery store for seasoning, child. Okay. And if you like different seasonings, you season to your style, your taste. But this is what we do. Then you get a little water, you get a microwave dish, and put like a half inch to inch of water. Not all the way up, just enough to get the steam in. I'm gonna be cooking these one at a time because I just have a small dish. One of these days I'll get a big dish. Uh-oh, and it's too big for this one. My squash I had yesterday was just right. Okay, I gotta cut a little bit of this off. Okay, and you put it upside down into the dish, in the microwave dish, like that. And I'm gonna put it in the microwave. Just a second. Excuse me, please. Oh. Okay, put it in the microwave and set it for the total cook time gonna be 2 minutes. So the first round I set it for 8 minutes. First one, I'll do it for 8 minutes. Then I'm gonna show you what I do next after it come out. So while we waiting for those 8 minutes, I'm gonna talk. Can we talk, y'all? I'm telling you, all my chronic pain sufferers who follow me, get some plant foods in your life. Things have changed subtly that I wasn't paying attention to. Things like my skin, my knees, and used to be so rough and dark like my elbows. They was darker than that. That has cleared up. My knees is like smooth, like a baby's butt, soft. Then a lot of phlegm comes up as I've been eating the Savvy way with the plant foods and eating alkaline. It has changed. It has changed and has had a positive effect. Example of, I wouldn't have been able to do this garden. I wouldn't have the energy. And I had gave up gardening a few years back. I got back into it and did a lot outside. So you, Miss Donna Woods, you get back to garden. If it's something that's bringing you pleasure, joy, don't give it up just because you got fibromyalgia. I started back because that was one of the things that was giving me, you know, comfort and peace. But the pain, the fatigue, nobody helping me, it made me give it up. But since I've been eating the Savvy way, I have been improving. And one of the improvements that has returned is energy. I never had that. When I go to sleep, it'll feel like I had went into a coma or something. It feel like I got hit by a Mack truck. When I try to wake up, like I got to peel myself off the bed. Since I've been eating this way, I be springing up out the bed like a kid. Yay! Like I'm going to school the first day. it has been a difference. I can't say cure, so don't get me wrong. Fibromyalgia is still there, but there have been subtle changes that has come as a result of changing my diet. Changing my diet. I left meat alone. I don't buy meat. I have not bought meat in 8 months, since October last year. only thing, I take that back, I'm lying. Christmas time, I bought chicken and shrimp for my gumbo, because I got a friend, that's what she like, and I like making it too. I might making it for her. And beyond that, I have not bought no meat. My diet has been all plant-based. And I'm telling you, it makes a difference. Another difference. This time of year, the spring, my allergies. We had a whole week of rain, right? It was like 3 days in a row, right? A whole week. I would be sneezing off the chain from that. I ain't even sniffing.
Okay.
I would have been sneezing and sniffling and went through rolls of toilet tissue. it's a trip. I have seasonal hay fever. I have not had any symptoms of it. The other thing, subtle, my knees, when I sit down at the computer, they be off the chain, burning, inflamed, burning pain. The whole time, the inflammation is gone. You hear me? Inflammation gone. I ain't feeling the burning sensation in my shoulder or my knees. So, I'm convinced. So this ain't just no fad for me. It just ain't no, just no one thing, you know, one time Sally, one hit wonder, whatever. This is it for life. This is it. I left the meat alone. I be going all around this town, y'all, being a leave that meat alone and that evangelist. I bumped into a girl and all these, she saw me stocking up on all the apple cider and wondered what I was gonna do with all that apple cider. I bought a case of it, y'all. I used this and baking soda on my feet. I had 3 toenails that were black. That in one day, two of the toenails just came off. It was like
the acid
loose. It's garlic. I used this and garlic. I don't know which one caused it, but the two of them. I soaked in the garlic and I soaked in the apple cider. Yeah. And then put the garlic on my feet, wrapped it around in saran wrap. I got a video of that, y'all. And y'all could see the difference from one day to the next. In one day, garlic helped my toenails. And so I'm convinced we should be eating plants. We got all these people that's with high blood pressure, diabetes. I really suspect strongly it's because we moved away from plant eating, plant diets. I believe that now.
Like Adam and Eve.
Yeah, you know. So let me go check on the progress of my spaghetti squash. Now, I got it out the microwave, and what I'm going to do, that was hot. Take cream cheese. Now, this is called new focaccia. I don't know if I'm saying that, pronouncing that right, but it's less fat in there. And while I say I gave up the meat, I ain't gave up cheese yet. I still like my cheese. And with this particular food dish, the reason why it got its name is because when it cooks, it shreds up like spaghetti. See how it shred up? Oh, and it's so good. So what I'm going to do is pull some of these threads away. And then mix it with the cream cheese. Now this dish, even the young people ain't got no excuse. All the ones that like to drive up to the fast food restaurant, this gonna eliminate your excuse. Mix the strands with the cream cheese. It's already been seasoned with garlic. I'm gonna put a little bit more in mine.
So it'll be a little bit easier to cream cheese at room temperature.
Yeah, I should have took it out. I forgot it'll be easier room temperature. I just got it out the refrigerator.
Okay, it's okay.
I'm a little distracted by company. I didn't think of everything. Okay, and I'm going to put a little bit more garlic salt for the strands I just pulled away from the edge. Okay, you see, I mix it up, stir it up, and these are like spaghetti strands. Now I'm going to pop it back in the microwave one more minute so the cheese be nice and melty. I'm telling y'all, this is good. One more minute. One more minute for us to jam. Now, no excuse. This is one thing you can do in 10 minutes. And that's way better than these things. And I'm telling you, we literally lived off of these hard times. Grabbing these. This is death right here. If you see the back of that label, look at all them words you can't pronounce. And then it's more sodium in this package than an average person needs in 2 days. In one package. No good. Leave them alone too. I used to swear by them, don't get me wrong, so I ain't judging. That's how I had to make it with some ramen noodles. But now that I know, I'm going to the store and get this for $1. And these things are so big, half of it is filling. If you got a family, you could cut this in four. You got little children, cut this in four. For $1, you can feed 4 people. Because this half of one is fully filling to me. All right. I'm going to finish off the second one and come back and get my friend's reaction when she tastes it. Okay?
Happily.
Okay, I'm getting ready to get my friend's reaction. This is her first time trying it. I've been trying to get her over here for the longest to try out something I cook.
Wow.
You like it?
That's good.
Yeah, yes. I got a new convert. I turned my son out. And now I'm waiting for mine. And that's way better than them doggone ramen noodles. Get them out your life. Put some spaghetti squash in your life. I mean, when I was younger, and I ain't judging, because if your mama didn't bring it home, she just didn't bring it home. You know, I made and cooked what my mama brought. So I did the collard greens and the soul food, pig feet, all kinds of pig. But I didn't know nothing about vegetables, what kind of pig. Some of them look exotic, you know. The eggplant looked weird to me. I made a dish with that fried, like you fry okra. Oh my God, delicious. Going to be growing that. She likes it. She likes it.
Good.
Hey, Mikey, she likes it.
It tastes good.
So, y'all, get on that. And I'm going to conclude this video. And after I eat my spaghetti squash, I'm gonna chillax. Next to, like they say, Netflix and chill. Netflix and chill. I ain't got Netflix. I got Amazon. I hope I could talk her into taking in a movie. But anyway, y'all see y'all again. Peace and love. Right, y'all have a good Friday. My turn. Yum. Woo, it's hot too, y'all. Superwoman thinks she could pick it up without. Yum. This is good, y'all. Mmm. Trying to tell y'all. This was happening.
The spaghetti sauce on it, make it even more.
Oh yeah, you can season it the way you like. Yeah. I like cheese with it and garlic.
I love the way you have it. I love it. I'm definitely gonna do this recipe.
Get you some. Cause you gonna think it's yum yum. Anyway. Now I'm really out this thing. Peace and love.
And cleanup is just a breeze.
Yeah, that's another advantage for this. No cleanup. No pots and pans, none of that stuff. So when you tired and exhausted like I was after a day of gardening, this all the work I want to do. But anyway. Let me get out this video before it be tomorrow, before you even get to see it. I want this to get up for Feel Good Friday. Mm. She loved it.
That shit was good. I need some water.
Oh, man. I've got to make a drink.
No,
I'll get back with y'all.
You're not giving me water right now.